Ladies, gentlemen, distinguished guests, thank the organisers for their very kind invitation to be able to join with you all today. And may I start off, first of all, by thanking Bury Council and Greater Manchester Police for helping in the arrangements of today. I have one or two very brief points to make. Firstly, what we have seen recently is nothing other than the annexation of an independent territory by India. This is against international law, and it is something that requires the strongest possible response from the international community, a response which at this moment in time is failing the basic rights of the people of Kashmir. As I address you today and as you all stand here, the world is silent in the face of the most atrocious human rights abuses that are taking place today, completely unfettered and completely unchecked and with impunity. Today, those soldiers and officials that are overseeing and indeed carrying out those human rights abuses know they do so with complete impunity. But very soon, the Indian courts themselves, the Indian Supreme Court, is going to have to rule on whether the action that has been undertaken is in accordance with the Indian Constitution itself. And therefore, it is imperative on the international community, including our government, to ensure that the Indian Supreme Court is able to carry out its deliberations and deliver findings in a free and independent manner, free from all obstruction or interference from the Indian political system. Because if there is one thing we currently know about the Indian administration, that is that it will not allow anybody to have any say on this matter that is not completely in line with how it seeks to propagate its position. That would be completely against natural justice, and we must not allow that to happen. And then what can we, as individual citizens of the United Kingdom, standing here carrying out our rightful ability to protest, what can we do further than what we are doing today? Well, very soon, we may well as a country find ourselves in a situation that we are able to conduct a bilateral free trade agreement negotiation with India. At the European Union level, those negotiations are currently ongoing, but they were stalled for some 6 years. And they were stalled because of a number of factors, including the fact that within the negotiating mandate, it had been included that whilst these human rights abuses are still being carried out in Kashmir with impunity, that these negotiations cannot be finalized. That clause was inserted by myself as a member of the European Parliament for the Northwest of England. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it may come to a point that the United Kingdom can start to make that decision outside of the European Union for itself. And what is absolutely essential is that your members of Parliament, whether they are from Bury or from the surrounding towns, and I know there are a number of local representatives here from a number of places, it is absolutely imperative that your members of Parliament understand one thing, that we as their constituents will not tolerate the United Kingdom finalising a free trade agreement with any country, whether it is India or anybody else, while such a situation exists in Kashmir. We will not allow it. And if, ladies and gentlemen, we are not able to make our voice heard in that debate which will take place, and that agreement is finalized, believe me, that will be a huge failure on the part of all of those right-thinking people in the United Kingdom. And in reality, if that happens, our feelings towards the people of Kashmir are nothing but feelings. We have nothing but words for them. What we can do is stand as a wall between India's progress whilst it carries out these atrocities. We are able to do that. And inshallah, God willing, we will. Thank you.
Meri jaan jawani
azadi,
meri jaan jawani
azadi,
meri jaan jawani
azadi,
main mar bhi gaya to
azadi,
main mar bhi gaya to
azadi,
main mar bhi gaya to
azadi,
ye hoon se likh do
azadi,
ye hoon se likh do
azadi,
ye lafz pyara
azadi,
badi izzat wala
azadi,
badi ghairat wala
azadi,
zara zor se bolo
azadi,
dushman ko suna do
azadi,
मोदी को सुना दो जरा जोर से बोलो दुश्मन को बुला दो थैंक यू
I would like to say assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh to everyone here listening to me right now. I would like to thank you, Uncle Tarek and Shabazz over here, for giving me the opportunity to speak out in front of all of you guys. So, they want us to write about Kashmir with our broken, aching heart. The paradise of earth who had crystal clear sapphire waters, clouds made out of silk and its gracefulness. It is not possible to admire the beauty of Kashmir. However, this paradise sheds tears every day. The skies fade grey, the sun becomes less bright and the days of hope die. The Indian army capture our land of Kashmir, the land of peace. They kill, rape and terrorize the innocent souls of Kashmir. How can we as humans stay silent? How can we ignore this painful tragedy? The Kashmiris are wounded, lost in all this distress, and their tired bones are waiting. But the only thing that goes for them is the Indian Army's fear. Think about it, ladies and gentlemen. Would you remain calm if 4,000 to 6,000 troops were patrolling around Bengal on a daily basis? There would be a sense of uncomfortableness raised immediately. Friday is the day of Azadi, also known as freedom. Women, children and the hopeless men cry out for Azadi, 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 while the rivers flow with red blood. Kashmir reigns for political gains. You think the leaders will help? Sorry, the only involvement is about the pocket. If we stand alone, we stand no chance. If we stand alone, we stand no chance. But when we stand as one, we can demand one message and we make it clear. We stand with you. We stand with Kashmir. Say free Kashmir. Free Kashmir.
Free Kashmir. Free Kashmir. Free Kashmir. Free Kashmir. Free Kashmir. Free Kashmir. Free Kashmir.
Free Kashmir. Free Kashmir.
Today I request all of you listening to me to take upon yourselves and do as little to post on your social media about justice for Kashmir. Thank you.
Distinguished guests, respected elders, brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. First of all, I would like to thank the organisers for giving me the opportunity to say a few words to you, Councillor Khalid, Councillor Rafiq, Councillor Daly. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak here in front of you. Obviously, we know what's been going on in Kashmir over the last 35 days, but this particular issue has been ongoing for the last 7 decades. And over the last couple of decades, I think, as Kashmiris and Pakistanis, we've actually been asleep, because there's been a war against terror in Afghanistan, and the Western countries have been deliberately going in there and tearing our Asian countries apart. But when it comes to dealing with India over the Kashmir, for one reason or another, they seem to be quiet. Here, we want to send a message to Modi, but what about sending a message to our Prime Minister, Boris Johnson? Has he said a word on the Kashmir issue so far? His Foreign Secretary has said a few words, but they've been half-hearted. What I want from you today is every single one of you here today will have a smartphone in your pocket. I want you to get that smartphone out of your pocket now
and send an email
to Boris Johnson. Come on, why are you? Come on, turn your phones out. I'll give you the email address of Boris Johnson. His email address is boris.johnson.mp@parliament.uk. Subject Kashmir and ask him, what has he done so far over the Kashmir issue? We've got women. Rape is being used as a weapon against our women in Kashmir. They're being raped on a daily basis. They've had no food, no medicine. They're under a blockade at the moment. They don't even know whether their neighbour at the end of the street is alive or not. They can't even contact them. Never mind contacting somebody at the other end of the world. So now, from now onwards, yes, we'll come to these demonstrations, but what I want from each one of you is to send an email to Boris Johnson every single day until this blockade is over. Because that's what you need to do. Every single day, put down Kashmir. Obviously, today it'll be 35 days. Tomorrow it'll be 36 days. Put down what is the British government doing, because they've got a moral and legal obligation to sort this mess out, because it was started by the British Raj when India and Pakistan was formed. So therefore, they've got a legal and moral duty to sort this issue out for us. And the other thing I wanted to mention to you all is, when you fill that ethnic origin form in, put down that you are Kashmiri. Be proud of being from the Kashmir region. Because for some one reason or another, we just seem to be shy to say that we're from Kashmir. From now onwards, I want you all to be proud of being Kashmiri. And thank you for listening to me.
Kashmir needs us. This is a time of need. And West must listen. Hitler is waiting in Modi's body. And when Pakistan and India, if they carry on like is going on in Kashmir, nuclear war will start. And if the war starts, it's going to end up in Europe. Europe will not live in peace. Thank you. Khawateen hazrat, main aapse ek guzarish karna chahta hu. Mujhse pehle ab speakeron ne apne apne andaaz mein guftgu ki, lekin mayus nahi hona chahiye. مایوسی کفر ہے. ہمارا دین یہ نہیں سکھاتا. دیکھیں 70 سال سے یہ تاریخ چل رہی ہے, لیکن برطانیہ کی سرزمین میں یہ پہلی بار آج ہمارے یہ بچے جس شہر میں جائیں کوئی سیاسی قیادت اس کا کریڈٹ نہیں لے سکتی. یہ اللہ کی طرف سے ہو رہا ہے. مودی نے بلنڈر کیا ہے. آج ہمارے بچے یہ سٹریٹوں پر نکل آئے ہیں. یہ بری کی سرزمین میں دیکھیں ہماری مائیں ہماری بہنیں. میں آپ سے گزارش کرتا ہوں, تاریخیں جو چلتی ہیں ان میں ہزاروں سال قربانیاں جنگیں لڑنی پڑتی ہیں. ہم مایوس نہیں ہیں, انشاءاللہ ہم آزادی لے کر آئیں گے. آج ہماری بچیاں ہماری بہنیں جن کو قتل کیا جا رہا ہے, ان کا خون کبھی رائے گا نہیں جائے گا. آپ بہنوں سے گزارش ہے, اپنی بچوں پر بچوں کی تعلیم پر نظر رکھیں. آنے والا وقت ہم ٹیبل کی میز پر جنگ لڑیں گے. ہمارا کشمیری بچے اگر پڑھے لکھے ہوئے تو ہم اپنی آزادی لے کر آئیں گے. ایک بار پھر بری تھینک یو.
السلام علیکم آل ڈسٹنگوشڈ گیسٹس, برادرز, سسٹرز اینڈ ریسپیکٹڈ ایلڈرز. First of all, I'd like to start by thanking all the organizers for this event today, for raising awareness. That's all this event is about today. We're here to raise awareness for what is happening with our brothers, our sisters, our mothers, our fathers, and our vulnerable children in occupied Kashmir. I'm not going to take too much of your time. Time is short, as I've been told. But one thing I'd like to say is, I'm proud to come from this community. I am proud to come from a Kashmiri background. I'm proud to call myself a Pakistani, a Kashmiri, because when it comes to it, we get together, we unite, and we make up the numbers. So I want to all of you to welcome to yourselves for turning up today for a small town in Berry. We've all turned up today. I mean, I was at the Oldham protest. They all turned up there. The day before, it was at a Kashmir conference. It was fully packed, and I just want to say well done to all of you for turning up. But it's not just about turning up. You need to understand, we need to do what counts. What makes that difference? The difference is going to be by you signing them petitions. Just to let you in on the knowledge side of things, you need 10,000 signatures on a petition to get through to the government, and you need 100,000 signatures on a petition to get your topic raised in the Houses of Parliament. So by us chasing our councillors and our MPs and whatnot, it won't make that difference unless you turn up and you sign the petitions. We live in a day and age of social media. All the petitions go around on our mobile phones. We don't even need to move from home. we can sign that petition. I really like what Councillor Shoaib Akhtar said before about sending the email across to the Prime Minister. If there is 500 people who send 2 emails each a day, it will take you 33 seconds. 33 seconds to send 2 emails. 2 emails, that's 1,000 emails at the top of his inbox. If we do that from here, we do that from Bolton, from Blackburn, from everywhere, you think, well, if we've got 10,000 emails going through to him, he will have to do something about it. He will have to do something about it. He will have to take action. So we need to do this all together and make sure that we do our part. Kashmir has been suffering for the last 72 years. 72 years. I heard over the last few days, I've been hearing people say 4 weeks, 6 weeks, 35 days. No, it's 72 years that brothers and sisters have been suffering. Let me make it very simple to you. You think if that was your daughter, I don't need to say much more than that. They are our brothers and sisters. This is not a fight against India or Hindus or anyone else. This is a fight for humanity. We need to stand up and show people we're Northerners. We're from the UK. We're British. We're British Pakistanis. We're British Kashmiris. We need to show people that we are diverse people. We are charitable people. We are caring people. And we need to stand up and make sure we get this message across to everyone. I want all you brothers and sisters to please make sure you do that. Just make sure we get across, we get our message across into the Houses of Parliament. Like I said, we need 100,000 signatures to get the topic raised. So we all make sure we do sign the petitions that go around and we do get through to everyone. And once again, I just want to say thank you very much for everyone who's turned up. And Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum, my brothers and sisters. Assalamu alaikum. It's good to be here in front of you today on this important issue. Thank you, Uncle, for your kind introductions. And thank you for all joining us here today from across the community, across political parties, across effort. And it is so important as a town, as a community, that we remain united with one single vision of freedom for Kashmir, of the right of the Kashmiri people to self-determine their future, to end the Indian occupation of Kashmir, and for Kashmiri people to be free to determine their lives and living thereafter. And I stood only this week in Parliament and met with the Prime Minister of Kashmir, and I stood in solidarity with him and I said this: we meet at a time where Britain's role in the world is under new assessment. What we do next will determine the next hundreds of years. But what we do now for Kashmir has to be more than standing in solidarity with them. And so I join the call, and in Berry I lead the call, that this government does more than talk about the issue of Kashmir, that this government has to act, not through military intervention, but humanitarian intervention. An end of human rights abuses. And the support for health and well-being and peace and prosperity for everybody living in Kashmir and across the region. And so I thank you all here for being here today. I am proudly a member of the All Party Parliamentary Group for Kashmir, a cross-party effort in Parliament to stand shoulder to shoulder with your efforts and call the government of any colour into account on this issue. I'm also proud to be the Vice Chair of the British and Pakistan Trained All Party Parliamentary Group, and am in the process of facilitating a trade visit to Pakistan to listen and learn for myself what you already know through family ties and deep generational links to Pakistan. So assalamu alaikum to you all. Thank you very much for having me. Well done for organising. And thank you all. God bless. Inshallah.
We speak for their future and their security. And these are the voices
that we want our politicians, certainly in Parliament, to acknowledge and understand. And it goes without saying, I think from our perspective in Bury North, we are very fortunate that we're able to raise our voices in this way in a local democracy, directly with our Member of Parliament, James Frith. And I hope in the same way as James is going to represent our voices and has been doing for the last 2 years, that other members of Parliament are also able to be courageous and stand for justice and fairness in Parliament and speak out against the inhumane actions that are taking place around the disputed territory. I'm ashamed to say that I feel that the UK government has for far too long been silent over the actions of Prime Minister Modi. And it is now time for Prime Minister Boris Johnson and the Foreign Secretary Dominic Raab not to sit behind decades of protocols, but actually to stand firm and take action and speak at a United Nations level, speak on a world stage level against the atrocities that are taking place on a daily basis to thousands of people across Kashmir, especially those young innocent children and mothers and sisters that are suffering. And I find it astonishing that we have individuals like Katie Hopkins, who finds it appropriate to criticise those who wish to demonstrate outside the Indian High Commission in London. Well, we've got a message for Katie Hopkins and other people of her ilk, that we live in the United Kingdom in a free and fair democracy. And as we're exercising our right today, so are people entitled to exercise their right to speak against the atrocities outside the Indian High Commission. So I know there have been hundreds and thousands speaking outside the Indian High Commission for many days now, and long may that continue, because that lobbying and that effort is much needed to ensure that the voices of all of us across the United Kingdom is one that reaches not only to the UK government, but also to the Indian government. And we have a duty. When we're asked that what did you do when it was heard about the suffering and the inhumane actions, we know that we came out onto the streets, we talked to our local representatives, we approached our local Member of Parliament, and were able to ensure that those that were suffering were able to have a voice. The United Kingdom especially has a duty to intervene, because it is a signatory to Article 25, which calls on the people of Kashmir to have the right to self-determination over the disputed territory. So if we are signatories to that article, we need to live to that effort. We need to ensure that we're representing the UK position and the UK government's position at every opportunity. So we must carry on this call and effort to ensure that the UK government is able to call out the inhumane actions of the Indian government and the Indian forces. I look forward to seeing many of you next week, when we're holding a public meeting facilitated by James Frith, the Member of Parliament, on the 14th of September at 2 o'clock at the Mosser Centre, where we'll discuss in more detail and hear from people who've got first-hand experiences of what's happening in the disputed territory. But I congratulate all the organisers for today. I congratulate all of you for turning out. And may long live Kashmir. May long live Kashmir. Long live Pakistan. Kashmir! Kashmir! Kashmir!
جی میری اطلاع کے مطابق اس وقت دواؤں کی سخت قلت ہے اور جو ہمارے پیلٹ گن کے وکٹنگز میں ہسپتالوں میں جگہ نہیں ہے گھروں میں پڑے ہوئے ہیں ادویات کی کمی ہے اور وہاں پر سری نگر میں میری اطلاع کے مطابق ہر روز کرفیو کی خلاف بندیاں توڑ کر ہماری بہنیں ہماری بیٹیاں ہمارے نوجوان باہر آتے ہیں اور گولیوں کا سامنا پیش کرتے ہیں اور آج یہاں مجھے خوشی ہے کہ بری کے اس ٹاؤن میں اس طرح کا جو وہ ان کے سولیڈیرٹی شو کرنے کے لیے جو اظہار یکجہتی کے لیے یہ پروگرام کیا گیا ہے میں ایک گزارش کروں گا کہ آزاد کشمیر کی گورنمنٹ کو ہمارے جو صدر ہیں مسعود خان صاحب ایک میچور ڈپلومیٹ ہیں ان کو اس عالمی پلیٹ فارم پر کشمیر کے مسئلے کو جو ہے وہ اجاگر کرنا چاہیے اور ریپرزینٹ کرنا چاہیے اسی طرح کشمیر کا مسئلہ جیسے کہ پچھلے کئی دہائیوں سے اس مسئلے کو ایک مخصوص بیانیے کو कोई भी दुनिया का मुल्क जो सपोर्ट करने के लिए तैयार नहीं है। हमें इस पर सोचना चाहिए कि हमें कौन सा वो बयानिया है जिस पर हमें दुनिया की हमायत की हमायत करेगी। इस वक्त दुनिया में जो वहाँ पर ह्यूमन राइट्स की वायलेशंस हैं उस पर तो मुख्तलिफ अतराफ से, मुख्तलिफ प्लेटफॉर्म से, मुख्तलिफ ममालक से हमारी हमायत और आवाज़ें उठ रही हैं, लेकिन हमारी आज़ादी के हवाले से कोई भी मुल्क इस वक्त देखते हैं कि पाकिस्तान तनहा है। इवन हमारे ब्रदर ममालक भी कमा हक हो वो साथ देने के लिए तैयार नहीं है। कहीं कोई हमारी इस बयानिए में, हमारी पॉलिसी में कोई खामी तो नहीं है? यकीनी तौर पर कहीं कोई ना कोई कोई गलती है, कोई खामी है। इस वक्त वहाँ श्रीनगर में जो गोलियाँ चलती हैं वो ये नहीं देखती कि ये इलाके पाकिस्तान का हामी है या ये खुद मुख्तार कश्मीर का हामी है। वहाँ पर मैं देख रहा हूँ मेरे दोस्तों और वहाँ के साथियों में से, वहाँ गनी लोन शहीद हुए, वहाँ लिबरेशन फ्रंट की क़यादत शहीद हुई, काजी निसार शहीद हुए, मीरवाज मौलवी फारूक शहीद हुए, मकबूल भट्ट शहीद हुए, अफजल गुरु शहीद हुए, बुरहान वानी शहीद हुए और ला तादाद हमारी शहदा की जो है वो एक लंबी दास्तान और तवील लिस्ट है। मैं आज शहदाए करबला के कुर्बानियों के वसातत से उन शहदा के जिन्होंने अजीम कुर्बानी दी और उनकी कुर्बानियों के सदके अल्लाह कश्मीरियों की मुश्किलात को आसान करे और हमारी कुर्बानियों को जो है और रायगांव होने से बचा ले। शुक्रिया।
ना मैं शहराग हूँ ना किसी का टूट अंग हूँ, सच तो ये है मैं दोनों काबजों की मुनाफ़त से तंग हूँ।
अस्सलामु अलैकुम रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहू। I am gathered here today for Kashmir and for justice for Kashmir, and I would like all of you watching me right now to post on your social media free Kashmir, as it's been tortured. The women in Kashmir and the children in Kashmir have been tortured, and we do not know what's happening in Kashmir, as there was a communication blackout for the past 35 days. Please keep Kashmir in your duas. Thank you.
We arranged a protest, a rally, a march, whatever you want to call it. It was basically a gathering to get the awareness across to everyone who doesn't know what's happening in Kashmir, and what we wanted to do is send the awareness across and let people know what is going on in Kashmir. And it is not a matter of Hindus killing Muslims or Muslims killing Jews, or it doesn't matter what color, creed, what background you come from. At the end of the day, what matters is humanity, and we want to bring humanity back into the world. Why is our parliament, why is our government sat there in their offices and they've not took no action whatsoever? My plea, I'm on my knees pleading to the government of the UK. You imagine if it was your daughter that was getting raped out there. You think if it was your son coming home with a shot, with a bullet shot through their arm. You think if you were living in the UK and your family, you don't know whether they're alive or not. It's a plea, Boris Johnson, I will say it directly to you. If your daughter was getting raped in Kashmir, what would you do? It makes shivers go up your spine just by saying that. Thank you.
आज मैं बरी की आवाम के बिहाफ मैं ये मोदी को पैगाम पहचाना चाहता हूँ कि मोदी तुम कितने कश्मीरी शहीद करोगे? अभी आज़ाद कश्मीर बाकी है, हम तुमसे एक एक मिनट का हिसाब लेंगे और तुम्हारी चिता वो गाय के मूत के साथ जलाएंगे, और तुमसे तुमने जो जुल्म की बरमार की हुई है कश्मीर के अंदर, इंशाल्लाह ताला कश्मीरी जो नई आने वाली जनरेशन है कश्मीरी, पूरी दुनिया में ये मैसेज मोदी तक पहुँचाएँ कि इंशाल्लाह ताला हम कश्मीर के बुज़ुर्गों, माओं, बहनों और बेटों जो अपने खून का नजराना दे रहे हैं आज़ादी कश्मीर के लिए, इंशाल्लाह हम तुमसे छीन के लेंगे आज़ादी। कश्मीर कश्मीरी जहाँ जहाँ हैं और जहाँ जहाँ हैं वो अपने आप को कश्मीर का एक सफीर समझते हुए कश्मीर की आवाज़ बुलंद करो और लोगों को बताओ और दुनिया को बताओ कि कश्मीर हक हक आज़ादी है।
सबसे पहले तो ये जो आज जलसे में आपने शिरकत की और उसका जो आपने मीडिया पे जो आप दे रहे हैं बहुत अच्छा है और काफ़ी कवरेज आ रही है, और उसके अलावा यहाँ पे बहुत आज गैदरिंग गैदरिंग है इधर जो है ना, मैं खुद ब्रिटिश कश्मीरी हूँ और जो मैं कंडेम करता हूँ कि जो मोदी कर रहा है वो गलत कर रहा है, और जो हमारी माएँ बहनें या बच्चे उधर जिनको अब्डक्ट कर रहे हैं ये स्टॉप होना चाहिए। और मैं गुजारिश से कहता हूँ कि जितने भी हमारे इधर काउंसलर्स हैं, 200-300 काउंसलर पूरे यूके में या मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट है, जितने भी हमारे इधर लोग हैं उनको जो है ना हमें ख़त लिखना चाहिए और इस कश्मीर इशू को जो है ना जागर करना चाहिए ताकि एक वाज बन के जो है ना हम इसको स्टॉप कर सकें।
कम आज बरी के आवाम ने साबित कर दिया है कि हम अपनी आर्मी के साथ चट्टान की तरह खड़े हैं। हम ये जुल्म कब तक बर्दाश्त करेंगे? हमारी माई बहनों बच्चों पर जुल्म हो रहा है। हम ये कौमी मुत्तहिदा से इतमाश करते हैं, गुजारिश करते हैं कि ये जो है ये फैसला जल्द से जल्द कराएं।
बाकी जो दीगर शहर है वहाँ पे जैसे बेशुमार प्रोग्राम है वो उनका इनकाद हो चुका है। आपको मालूम होना चाहिए कि जो मोदी ने एक बड़ी गलती की है, एक्ट ख़त्म कर गए, उसने जो कश्मीरी और पाकिस्तानी बच्चा बच्चा है उसको जगा दिया है। अभी एक तहरीक का जो है वो आगाज़ हो चुका है और जो बच्चा बच्चा एक ही बात कर रहा है कि हमें आज़ादी चाहिए। तो अभी कोई भी दुनिया की जो ताकत है वो इस आज़ादी को नहीं रोक सकती। मोदी ने ख़ुद हमें उठा दिया है, हमें जगा दिया, हम सोए हुए थे, हमें जगा दिया है आज़ादी के लिए। और इंशाल्लाह ताला मैं आपको ये बताना चाहता हूँ कि अभी कोई ताकत इस मसले को नहीं रोक सकती। दूसरा ये है कि बरी में पहले इस तरह का कोई बड़ा प्रोग्राम नहीं हुआ था, तो मैं भी बैरून मुल्क में मौजूद था, पाकिस्तान में था, तो मैं यहाँ पर आया और मैंने सोचा कि इस तरह का जो प्रोग्राम है, और सबसे बड़ी बात इस प्रोग्राम की है कि तमाम जो आल पार्टी ये प्रोग्राम हुआ है, तमाम जो इंग्लैंड की और जो पाकिस्तान की पार्टियाँ हैं उन्होंने भरपूर शिरकत की है और यहाँ पर कश्मीर के साथ यकजहती कदार किया है। और इसके साथ ही साथ मैं तमाम जो मीडिया है उसका भी शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहता हूं, और साथ ही साथ जो हमारी बहनें हमारे बच्चे भी यहां पे मौजूद थे और जो दीगर लोग हैं वो भी यहां पे मौजूद थे, उन तमाम का मैं शुक्रिया अदा करता हूं। और अक़वामे मुत्तहिदा से एक गुजारिश करता हूँ कि बराए मेहरबानी जो कश्मीर में 35 दिनों से कर्फ्यू लगा हुआ है फौरी तौर पर उस पर कोई उठे और जाएँ। भारत अगर झूठ नहीं बोल रहा तो क्यों नहीं जो ओवरसीज़ के लोग हैं यहाँ पर जो इंसानी हकूक की तंजीमें हैं उनके नुमाइंदों को क्यों नहीं इंडिया में जाने देता? हम हमारे जो वजीरे खारजा हैं उन्होंने तो कहा है कि आप एनी टाइम आए और कश्मीर में जो एलओसी पाकिस्तान के अंडर में कश्मीर है वहाँ पे जाकर आप देखें। तो इंडिया को भी ये बात करनी चाहिए, इंडिया को भी दिखाना चाहिए अगर वो कोई गलत नहीं काम कर रहा, वो बच्चों के साथ ज्यादती नहीं कर रहा, औरतों के साथ ज्यादती नहीं हो रही, हमारे जो कश्मीरी नौजवान हैं उनके साथ ज्यादती नहीं हो रही, तो इंडिया को किस बात का डर है? वो क्यों नहीं इंसानी हकूक की तंजीमों के जो नुमाइंदे हैं उनको वहाँ जाने की इजाज़त दे रहा?
पाकिस्तान इज अबाउट टू टेक एनी मेजर नेसेसरी टू स्टॉप बाय पीपल इन कश्मीर बट ऑन प्रेसिडेंट इन कम्युनिकेशंस ब्लॉक आउट कंटिन्यूज अ डे आफ्टर द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट संडे वुड रिवोक द टाइटल्स स्पेशल स्टेटस एंड डिवाइड इनटू टू एट लीस्ट 6 पीपल हैव सिंस बीन इंजर्ड इन प्रोटेस्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू सोर्सेस कोटेड बाय by agents France Pressy, with one traveler returning from Srinagar, Kashmir's biggest city, reporting here is good fire and other weapons being fired.